5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। मिस्टर चेयरमैन सर, मे आई हैव द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस डिबेट। दिस इज़ अ प्राइवेट मेंबर्स बिल एंड आई वांट टू कांग्रेचुलेट द मूवर ऑफ दिस बिल फॉर हैविंग ब्रॉट दिस बिल। अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट हैज बीन रेज्ड, दैट राइट टू वर्क शुड बी मेड अ फंडामेंटल राइट। राइट टू वर्क इज द बर्थ राइट ऑफ एवरीबडी, हाउएवर पुअर और हाउएवर रिच, वेदर अ मैन और अ वोमैन। वी हैव राइट टू प्रॉपर्टी एज अ फंडामेंटल राइट इन आवर कंट्री, बट इट इज़ रियली सैड दैट राइट टू वर्क विच प्रोवाइड्स राइट टू लिव शुड नॉट बी मेड अ फंडामेंटल राइट एंड शुड ओनली बी अ डायरेक्टिव प्रिंसिपल। वाई हैज़ दिस हैपेंड? वाई कुड इट नॉट बी मेड अ फंडामेंटल राइट टिल नाउ? इट इज नोन दैट वंस इट becomes a fundamental right, it becomes justiciable. That means that a person can go to the High Court or the Supreme Court and pay that it is his fundamental right and he must get a job. But as the government was not sure that it would be able to provide employment to every citizen, it did not do so. Because a fundamental right cannot be made only for a particular age groups, it is for all citizens, and every unemployed citizen can come to the court and claim his right for a job to be given to him. That was the real apprehension, reluctance on the part of the government, but this helps us to reach a larger economic issue of how we can create conditions in our country where every work worthy person would have a job. It is this subject which is being debated, and this is what should be debated as the most important subject in the parliament and in the country today. Unfortunately, I find very few people taking interest in this. Today, if we just introspect and sit a little coolly and consider how much energy is being wasted on trying to win debating points, trying to be sensational, trying to have mere superficial debate in this country, we will find that we are doing that too much. But the real issue is how to provide employment to every young man of this country, because after all, what is socialism? When we say that we have pledged ourselves in the preamble that we will establish a democratic, socialist, secular, sovereign republic, what does it mean? What is socialism? It means all members of our society must have an equal opportunity to live a decent human life. Such conditions must be created in our society where every single individual should have that right. That is the simple meaning of the word socialism, a society where a few do not have an opportunity and a right to exploit and extort. Such a society should be created, and this is what socialism means. And to bring it about within the framework of a democratic structure, that is, by the will of the people, is the meaning of the concept which our founding fathers have enshrined in the Constitution when they said that we will have two democratic socialist society. Let us ask ourselves this question: have we succeeded in doing it? When I am participating in the debate today, I am not going to speak from the point of view of winning or scoring the debating points between people on this side or that side. I think it is the duty of all of us. These 800 people in this house and in that house who have been entrusted by 80 crores of people of this country with the task of doing something that will change their destiny and change their life, it is incumbent on us to sit down and to give the topmost priority to consider as to how we can achieve this. And if this is given priority, sir, I am sure a way can be found. Instead of wasting our energy on other matters, let us concentrate on this matter. I am absolutely one with my friends when they say that this should be given the top priority. What do the young people of this country expect? Why are they restive? Why are they frustrated? It is because they are not employed. They do not have productive employment, creative employment. That is why they feel frustrated. By and large, if this is the fact, sir, then let us consider how this can be achieved. If you want to provide employment, that employment must be productive. What is wealth? Wealth is goods and services. It is not notes. The currency notes are actually the means of exchange. The wealth is goods. When do you see that a man is poor? It is when he is not able to have even the necessities of life. Now, how can you make them available to him? Obviously, first they must be produced, and then he must have the purchasing power to buy them. How can he have the purchasing power unless he has remunerative work?